the course has been designed to just cater to the needs of the requirements of becoming a good strategic thinker and a strategic analyst. So after passing out from master's program, they get jobs in the think tanks, and those think tanks, which mainly specializes in the field of national security, foreign policy and international relations.
After completing my PhD, I would preferably like to join the academics in the teaching field. I would also be open to working into research institutes, in think tanks in India as well as across the world.
Those of them who would like to pursue a career in diplomacy, to become diplomat, obviously they have to appear for civil service examination. And this course will help them in terms of preparation.
Usually you will find only political science students pursuing everywhere in India this particular course on geopolitics. But out here, there are a whole range of people who are doing this course, from engineering to political science to English to psychology to communication. So it's not just restricted to one particular course. Courtesy Manipal University, I got an opportunity to go abroad as well on a fellowship provided by Erasmus Mundus. So I spent 10 months in Leiden University. From Europe, I got a lot of data, which probably I wouldn't have got from India, especially on the theoretical aspects, because these are theories which mostly evolved in the Western countries, and we are trying to apply a lot of that in the Indian context. I went to Mussoorie, Dehradun, Delhi, Rajasthan. So it's a lot of experience that Manipal tries to provide in terms of giving you that exposure to the field before you actually start writing your thesis.
Manipal has given me a lot of avenues. Like, for example, it had helped me in getting internships in think tanks in Delhi as well as in Bangalore, with the help of which I had come up with a lot of publications, including a monograph. And I also got into touch with a lot of experts in India as well as outside through Manipal University.
There is an internship that that we have to do, and you know, and we get a publication during the course of your master's, which is not easy to do. So this department kind of drives you to do things beyond your experience before you join the department.
The way we conduct research here, it is meant to translate what we read in theory and put it across as policy recommendations for the government. I mean, it is up to the government to take it or not. The transfer of ideas from academic the policy field will then definitely affect the public.
The way each members of the international community has been eyeing on India, and they want to find out more about India, I think more and more scholars in this area would be required. And the way we have designed our curriculum, where area specific experts would be required. So again, I will just give you one example. India would require a number of good specialists working on West Asia, East Asia, China, Pakistan, the United States, counter-terrorism. You see the way the things really have been evolving. And these requirements, mainly in terms of understanding that in what ways India can evolve a policy which could address to the challenges emanating from the global security front as well as India's national security front.